shall now look at the second method of developing surfaces. This is the radial line development method. It is used to get the developments of objects having slant edges like pyramids, cones, etc. Here, the apex of the object is assumed to be hinged and the object is rolled about its axis. The area covered by the lateral surface of the object becomes the development of the object. Fine, let's construct a development of a cone which appears as a series of triangles. The area covered will be in the form of a sector of a circle with a subtended angle theta. The subtended angle theta is obtained by the formula radius of the base circle divided by the true slant length of the cone multiplied by 360 degrees. In the figure, a cone rests on the HP. A section plane perpendicular to BP and inclined at 30 degrees to HP bisects the axis of the cone. Let's draw the development of the truncated cone. Observe its orthogonal views. The top view appears as a circle on HP, showing the true shape and size of the base. The front view will be a triangle and the base coincides with the reference line XY. Now, divide the circle in plan into 12 equal parts. Let's draw vertical projectors from these points to meet the reference line XY and further join them to the apex of the cone. We see that the vertical trace MN of the cutting plane inclined at 30 degrees to HP bisects the vertical axis. Also, MN cuts the slanting edges of the cone. The outer slanting edges of the cone represents the true length of the cone. This is obtained by taking the square root of the sum of squares of altitude and half base. This value is 158.1. The subtended angle theta is obtained using the true length. In the front view, project point 1 dash onto the slant edge O dash A dash to get the point 1 double dash. Similarly, project points from MN to the slant edge O dash A dash and mark the points. Now we look at the development of the cone. With any point O and O dash A1 dash as radius, draw an arc subtending an angle of 113.85 degrees. From the starting point A of arc, mark 12 equal divisions of the arc. Joining these points to the apex O gives the development of the whole cone. Now, let's look at the development of the truncated cone. Mark point 1 on OA such that O1 is equal to O dash 1 double dash. Similarly, locate the rest of the points from 2 to 12 and 1 and join them to get the development of truncated surface. We just learned how to create developed surfaces of various geometric solids using radial line methods.